Hello everyone, today we'll see how to install CentOS 7 on our Oracle VM VirtualBox Manager. So let's start. You have to click on New, then give your system a name. I'll give it its KTS Master. Then you can choose where you want to store this particular server. So I'll choose it here. Next, you choose the type as Linux and we'll give it as Red Hat 64-bit. Go to next, and then you can choose the memory size. By default it is chosen as 1 GB, so next go there and create a virtual hard disk. Now so we'll create a virtual hard disk. I will use the format as VMDK. Go next and we'll use dynamically allocated. Here it is by default taken as 8 GB. I'll take it as 16 GB and then do create. So you can see that I have a machine created here, like the schema created here. We'll have to install the OS in it. So what you have to do is go to settings and here come to the storage. On the storage part, you have to go to the IDE and click on this, and what you can choose is choose your ISO file where you have the ISO file. You can choose it here. I have the CentOS 7 DVD over here. I'll just choose it, and then what I can do is just click on OK and now start the machine. It will boot from the ISO that we have just assigned to it. We'll see that. You can see here it is called, like there are three options here. You choose install CentOS 7 and then click enter. On this prompt, choose the language, click on continue. Here, choose your time zone. I'll choose the time zone here. Then click on done. This is automatic partitioning selected. If you want to format it as per your needs, like you want to give the size of your root boot bar home file system, you can give it here. I'll leave it as it is. And I'll just click it here. Click on done. And you can see this button has come activated now. You just do a begin installation. Here you have to choose the root password you want to set. I'll set the root password. Click on done. You can create another user here. I will not create anything, so I'll just log in as root. It is now doing the post installation steps. And now it's generating the init RAMFS. After this, it will ask us to reboot, and once we reboot it, it will give us a login prompt. And we'll see how to assign an IP to this system and try to accessing it. We'll now reboot the system. Just click on reboot. We'll now log in with the root credentials we have. It's now log in, so we'll check the IP. We have a local loopback IP and we don't have any other IP, so we'll configure an IP here. Edit connection, add. So let it be like that, or we can just change it to 880. We'll configure a IPv4 IP address. So let's add that IP address 192.168.1.110. And then we'll do leave this DNS server entries, and let's add a DNS server. Let's add Google's DNS server. Search domains will not add anything, and we'll disable IPv6 configuration, and let's it be automatically connected and click on OK. Now what you have to do is go back. You need to activate a connection 880. It's already activated, or you can deactivate and activate it again. Now quit. You can see there is an IP here. There is an IP here we have just configured, 192.168.1.110. So I'm using mremote-ng, so you can use PuTTY, or you can use this mremote-ng, which is again using PuTTY in the back end. So our server IP address is 192.168.1.110. So let's do SSH. We'll log into the system. We're now logged in. Thanks for watching this video.